The church has forever been involved in conflict with the kingdom of darkness, having to contend with the devil and his demons, who are like roaring lions continually seeking for whom to devour. The church need not be cut off guard. The nature of the struggle, which is getting fiercer by the day, has sometimes been misunderstood by followers of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because many of them have not been sufficiently aware to appreciate the nature of the struggle, let alone the resources at the disposal of every foot soldier of the cross. Little wonder the Lord commanded his disciples to go and reproduce others like them, who will take the battle to the territory of the enemy. It is for this reason that the mandate of establishing a school where every born-again and spirit-filled believer, irrespective of denomination, educational level, job status, and sex, who are willing to be a member of the last day army of the Lord, will be fired up and mentored, fell on the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, by the leading of the Holy Spirit in 1985.
What the Bible says we should be aware of is the wiles of the devil.
The school, which is coordinated by the teaching bureau of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, has its motto as greater works than this, which is taken from the book of John chapter 14 verse 12, and the mandate to go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, as espoused in the book of Matthew chapter 28 verse 19. The objectives for the establishment of the school include to produce disciples who will do the work of Jesus, to train dynamic soldiers of the cross for this end-time warfare, to equip faithful men who will in turn teach others, and to impact basic teachings on every area of Christian living and service. So, on the 16th of January 2016, a group of committed souls yearning for a richer and deeper relationship with the Lord, and even the battle cry to enlist as a soldier of Christ, enrolled to be part of this ever-growing community of disciples as they began their session. The following month would later become a period where disciples learned to shed the wrinkled skin of self and imbibe exemplary virtues such as sacrifice, sharing, brokenness, togetherness, unity, humility, and being teachable. Not only were they taught to be a terror to the enemy, but they also had the fire of compassion stoked up within them as they reached out to color the nondescript town of Okinla, a rural settlement on the outskirts of Lagos, with the good news of salvation and with soulish warmth of touching the lives of the inhabitants in a practicable way.
When I think upon your goodness and your faithfulness each day, I'm convinced it's not because I am worthy to receive the kind of love that you give.
The Okinla outreach has been on for some time, but it was eventually completed to the glory of God by this graduating class of 2016.
With the fencing of the church premises,
the students went all out to raise funds and left no stones unturned in ensuring the completion was a success. So, on September 18, 2016, the disciples set out to the sleepy town of Okinla to commission the newly built Greater Works Parish and reach out to the community with humanitarian needs. Undeterred by the difficult terrain en route the town caused by the heavy downpour, the disciples trudged on with the love of Christ in their hearts as they became the August visitor who made the month of September one to remember for the inhabitants of the town.
Who am I, Lord?
The new parish was commissioned to the glory of God, which saw several souls won to the kingdom. Then, several number of them were given medical attention, fed, and got new clothes and shoes from the disciples. They were full of joy for this kind gesture, which clearly demonstrated the love of Jesus Christ. The other remarkable project accomplished by this victorious graduating set was the purchase of a bus for the school. The bus, an 18-seater Toyota Hiace, will be used for evangelical purposes and for smooth running of the school activities for the region. The following disciples have shown the purposeful leadership in the last 1 year and are worthy of mention. Pastor Richard Murray, the Provincial Coordinator, Lagos Province 4 and Chairman, School of Disciples, Region 20. Coordinators, Pastor Bernard Mbang, Administrator, SOD Lagos Province 4. Mr. Olaolu Ajao, Governor, City of David Center.
Michael Bassi,
New Covenant Center. Adenike Obison, Glory Worship Center. Kufre Abasi Essien, Hope Hall Center. Glory Asukwo, Pillar of Truth Center. Jasmine Tamunosiki, Canaan Land Center. And here is not forgetting everyone who has been of immense support, both financially and morally. God bless you. It's been a great year so far. We have bonded well with one another, shared memories of joy, togetherness, we've prayed together, we've shared each other's burden, we've eaten together, and it has come time for us to bow out graciously, to be unleashed into the world and make a difference in our little spaces. Your labor of love will never go unrewarded in Jesus' name.